Hands-free driving is all the rage in America, and joining Cadillac Super Cruise and Ford's new Blue Cruise system soon is going to be teammate from Lexus. This looks like it's going to beat the hands-free driving system that we're going to see from Jeep coming up later. Lexus is calling it teammate, and there are a bunch of different sensors added to the LS that already has a ton of different autonomous and semi-autonomous driving sensors all around the vehicle. Let's take a look at the sensors first, and then let's get the vehicle out on the road. One of the first things to know about teammate is that Lexus is going about the system a little bit differently than some of the other car companies. They've brought along a number of pre-production LS500H all-wheel drive models. That is the only model that teammate will be available in at the beginning. Lexus is calling teammate a level 2 semi-autonomous system, so this is driver engaged all the time while driving. Teammate will use an additional suite of sensors that build on the sensors we find in the regular LS500. So you'll notice we have an additional sensor right down there at the bottom of the bumper. We also have parking sensors that are ultrasonic and a combination of long range, short range radar, a bunch of different camera systems, and in this vehicle, LiDAR. Although Lexus has not said whether or not the LiDAR sensors all the way around the vehicle will end up being in the final production version. The next module that's been updated versus the regular LS500 is the module right here behind the windshield. This has a bunch of different cameras. You can see we have the regular stereo camera set up there, and then two different cameras in that module right there as well. There are cameras in the side view mirrors, two cameras under the Lexus logo in the back. The most interesting sensors on this vehicle are the ones that we may or may not get in the final production version. These are additional LiDAR sensors that are really well integrated into the front quarter panels. You'll also find them in the front of the vehicle and in the back of the vehicle. They give the LS500 a much better idea of what's going on around the car. As vehicles move towards greater and greater levels of autonomy, we're going to start seeing LiDAR in more and more vehicles. I know there is a particular manufacturer out there that's not really keen on LiDAR, but that's primarily cost-based. LiDAR is a bit more of an expensive technology, however, it has a lot of benefits. If we're talking about a camera-based system like this in strong sunlight, the camera may not be able to see what's going on next to you. It can give the vehicle a blind spot, and we don't get that with LiDAR-based systems like this because they're sending out laser light, they're actually recording what's around the vehicle, it's being captured back into the sensor. Now, the problem with sensors like this up front is that bugs can end up on the sensor, and that's why this vehicle also backs things up with radar sensors around the vehicle, short and long range radar sensors that you would typically see in the average blind spot monitoring system. But radar sensors don't tell you exactly what is next to you. They'll tell you that something is next to the vehicle and its approximate speed and distance from the vehicle, but can't really tell what it is. That's where the LiDAR and the optical-based systems come in. The Lexus teammate system found on the LS500 in the Japanese domestic market does not contain the LiDAR sensors on the side or in the rear. Lexus is testing to see whether or not these sensors improve the functionality of the teammate system, and so they may or may not be in this generation of teammate. I expect them to be in some future version because obviously they've spent a lot of time integrating them into the body of the vehicle, and this is a much more seamless integration than, for instance, the upcoming second generation version of the Volvo XC90, where it has a big pod right on the top of the XC90, sort of like the bulb on a beluga whale, I guess you'd say. This is a much more elegant solution. So I've got the camera set up so you can see how the vehicle is behaving out on the road, and of course one where you can see the instrument cluster that's giving you the cues. Keep in mind, this is a level 2 semi-autonomous system. So it's not full autonomy, it's not attempting to be full autonomy. This is logically substantially similar to Cadillac Super Cruise system and Ford's new Blue Cruise system, with a few tweaks that are specific to Lexus. The system offers essentially two basic modes, one where there's a very aggressive lane centering feature, and then another where it's completely hands-free. As long as you're paying attention to the roadway and the system has identified the roadway as viable for that particular drive mode. You can see on the instrument cluster that now it has said that we are hands-off, but very much like Super Cruise and Blue Cruise, you have to be paying attention, you still have to be looking at the road. There also may be times where you have to put your hands on the steering wheel, and although I haven't had too much time with the system just yet, it does appear to be a little bit less aggressive at staying in the completely hands-free drive mode than either Ford's new system, which will be available in June or July of this year, and the Cadillac Super Cruise system, which is now on its second generation of hands-free driving. The first generation of Cadillac Super Cruise was not as smooth as far as its lane centering goes as this vehicle right here, but it does appear to be a bit more aggressive at actually staying in that self-driving mode. It's worth noting that all of these systems that I've talked about so far rely on high-definition maps of the road surface, and therefore are a little bit different than what Tesla is trying to do with their semi-autonomous driving systems. Of course, Tesla has two different formats of that. They have autopilot, and then they have their quote-unquote full self-driving, which is also described as a level 2 semi-autonomy system by their official filings. Both of those systems are attempting to do what Lexus, Ford, and General Motors are doing right here, but without LiDAR-based systems. So they tend to be a little bit less accurate as far as road holding and road keeping, but they are designed to operate on different types of roadways than simply limited access highways. Of course, relative concerns about safety and liability and all of that out the window, Tesla is attempting to do something a little bit different than here, so that is important to keep in mind. The displays and the indications in the system are substantially similar to what we're seeing from other manufacturers out there, only rather than having an LED integrated into the steering wheel as General Motors does, they've decided to go with colors on the full LCD instrument cluster, making it just a bit different as far as user interface goes. But largely, the functions of the system remain the same, and one of the critical features that we find in this and the Ford and the General Motors system that we do not see in any of Tesla's systems is a more aggressive driver attention monitoring system. So we actually have basically facial tracking right here with this little system behind the steering wheel. Probably one of the reasons it just turned off was I stuck my hand in front of it there. This is very similar to what we see in Super Cruise and Blue Cruise, and it means that the car is actually able to tell what I'm doing and how I am paying attention or not to the road surface in front of me, something that is definitely lacking with Tesla systems. So as far as safety goes, obviously this is not the kind of system you'll be able to operate from the back seat, and that's really for a very good reason. It's best if your car doesn't run over people. Much like some of the other systems that are driver attention monitoring, keep in mind that depending on the kind of glasses that you wear, mine are a little bit anti-reflective coating here. Also, polarized lenses seem to cause a problem with this kind of attention monitoring system because they're attempting to track not just your face location, but some of them will also attempt to track eye movements. The system will operate a little bit differently if you have a navigation destination entered into the infotainment system. Here, it's going to make specific recommendations based on lane position, exiting the freeway, etc., in order to guide you to your destination. So in this respect, it's a little bit different than some of the other drive assistant systems that we see out there that are not quite as integrated as this particular one with the infotainment system and the destination. Now, it's worth noting that this particular system is not using the new next generation Lexus infotainment system that we are going to see in the new 2022 Lexus NX. The system also automates lane changes, so if you prefer to drive into the next lane, you can indicate the lane change with the turn signal. And then now it will ask me to hold the steering wheel a little bit. It will then initiate the lane change. I'm not doing much other than just sort of hanging on to the steering wheel, giving a little bit of pressure, and then it will automatically turn off the turn signal when the lane change is complete. You then have to wait for the system to allow you to go hands-free now that we're in this lane, and then I can return to hands-free mode. The system will also suggest lane changes based on traffic around you, so if you've hung out in this particular lane a little bit too long, it will suggest returning to the right, which I can go ahead and do now. I'll do the same process here. You do have to... Oh, it canceled it there. You do have to look at the blind spot. That's the way the system acknowledges that you have decided to accept the lane change here. So hold the steering wheel, look at the blind spot. It will then take over, change lanes there, and now you're in the lane that you intended to. It will also do the same sort of thing recommended based on your navigation destination. The lane changes are not quite as aggressive as some of the driver assistance technologies out there that are currently level 2 in operation. Some of those are a little bit more abrupt, but the system, if it's recommending the lane change for you, it will automatically turn on the turn signal, which is a handy touch. As you can see now in this display, it's asking if we'd like to move to a faster lane. I'm just going to go ahead and ignore that because, of course, we're actually in the lane that we want to be for the exit. But the system has detected the slower traffic around us, and it knows that the traffic to the left is moving a little bit faster than we are. And there you have it. That's how Advanced Drive, part of the new Lexus Teammate driver assistance technology, works. They're calling this, again, a level 2 semi-autonomous system, not a full autonomous system, so definitely keep in mind those limitations. As far as its general theory of operation, keep in mind this is still a prototype system for the North American market, even though it is on sale elsewhere around the world. Bearing in mind that the software version that this vehicle is running is a prototype build of the software package, I would say that this is just about as polished as the first version of Cadillac Super Cruise. And it's worth noting that that is the version that we're going to be seeing in a number of General Motors vehicles. For instance, the new Chevy Bolt EUV is running version 1 of that software, not the next generation that we see in the Cadillac system. And the Lexus LS500 is just about as expensive as a Cadillac with Super Cruise at this exact moment. Of course, we don't know exactly how much the LS500H is going to cost with this particular package on it, but expect that particular package cost to take the LS500 up well into the six digits. If you haven't already done so, be sure to hit that subscribe button at the bottom of your screen so you can be updated on all of my latest videos, including a full review, just as soon as I can get my hands on a production version of this software. I'll see all of you later.